Welcome back to Mirror and Thread. It is my very favorite sale of the year. It's time for the Nordstrom anniversary sale. And this year, I went absolutely nuts and tried on basically everything in this store for you. So you can see what everything looks like on an actual human. And I will put all the links in the video description and we're gonna jump right in. So first of all, I'm going to go over the shoes because the Nordstrom sale is always about the shoes to me. If I don't purchase anything else, I always get on and make sure that I'm grabbing my fall staple shoes. This is the best time of year to snag them. The selection is amazing. The sale prices are great and you will not regret spending a little bit more on shoes. In my opinion, if you're gonna spend money on anything or spend a little extra or buy the more expensive thing, make it shoes. So I got lots of gray pairs to share with you, and I just stuck these all in here, so packaging might not look all that great, but starting off with the good old classic, this pair of booties. I feel like some version of this Steve Madden booty has been in the Nordstrom sale since I've been doing this, so 5 or 6 years, and every year these sell out like crazy, and I have snagged several different pairs of these over the years, and I always absolutely wear them out in the fall and winter season. So this is a little notch booty. These are crazy comfortable for the heel that you have. These are a really great everyday boot. You can wear these with absolutely anything, dresses, jeans, skirts, all the things. And this is the taupe color, and they run true to size. So it's actually the very first purchase that I made at the Nordstrom sale this year, and also the first thing on my wish list this year. How adorable are these sneakers? These are everything that I've ever wanted out of a sneaker. So I feel like they have enough cushion on them that you could do a workout in these, you could walk in these and still feel like you have great support, but they have that kind of street style look to them that makes them really cute just with little dresses or with jeans, with joggers, travel outfits. These are just going to be such a good go-to shoe all fall, really all seasons. You can wear these in the summer as well, of course, and that is great too. So the tongue has this kind of fun little textured detail on it, and these do come in several other color options. I imagine that this black and white is going to be a hot seller. When I purchased these in store, they were already running out of sizes really, really quickly. So if you want these, I would scoop them up as fast as you can. All right, this is my other favorite shoe purchase of the year, of the sale for sure. This is an UGG boot, and it is cuter than any other UGG boot I've ever seen. This has some really fun detailing. Again, this is going to be the most popular color. They also come in a black and in a dark brown. I anticipate that this is going to be a really great seller and will probably sell out pretty quickly. So these have a zipper, and it has a little UGG logo here, but look how cute. If you unzip, it even has the UGG logo in here, which I feel like even just to throw them on and not zip them, if you're like wearing them around the house or just running a quick errand, then you still kind of look put together and it looks a little bit intentional too. But these are the shearling, true shearling on the inside. Very warm, very soft. These are great with leggings, with joggers, jeans, all the things. And I love a shorter UGG boot. I just feel like they're a little bit easier to take on and off, and a little bit more flattering than some of the longer versions. And these are true to size as well. Next up is a pair of shoes that I'm actually wearing. I literally bought these and then wore them out of the store because I love them so much. This is another thing that they do. Steve Madden does basically some version of this shoe pretty much every fall. I've had similar versions of these the last couple of years in the Nordstrom sale, and sometimes I buy like the white or the pink, or they have lots of fun color options, and I always wish that I would have just gotten the tan because these get a ton of wear for me. I love doing them since I don't do work wear. I love doing these with just jeans and sweaters. They're really cute with skirts, but these do make a fabulous work wear shoe. They're slip-on. You will not get anything more comfortable. These are just such a good shoe that you can wear over and over and over. And they've been in style for years and will be in style for years to come. Lastly, for my shoe purchases, this is a really great option for a knee-high boot. I am only 5'3", so I personally don't love the over-the-knee boots as much. I just find them a little too overpowering for my shorter legs, and so I feel like this length is perfection. These don't fit super tight to the calf, so they still have a little bit of wiggle room. It's actually elastic here on the side too, but I feel like these are just a little bit more comfortable to walk around in, and if you do have a wider calf, then these will probably fit you better than some of the more narrow options. They have several similar options in the Nordstrom sale, but these are by Dolce Vita, and I feel like they're really comfortable, very practical, and will go with everything. Alrighty, moving into the clothing portion, and I tried all of these things on for you and kind of styled them in store, so I'm going to show you all the outfits actually styled in a try-on as well. So the very first thing I tried on was this simple striped sweater from Madewell and a pair of button front Madewell denim. These were a black straight leg jean. These are, I believe, intended to be an ankle fit or a cropped fit. Of course, as someone has 5'3", these fit me as a full length jean, which I was also fine with. And I had the size 28 in the jeans and a medium in the sweater. And the sweater also comes in black and white. And then the fedora hat, if you don't have a good fall fedora hat, highly recommend these. I have one from this brand from last year, and it has held up really, really well, and they keep their shape fantastically. So this belted camel coat definitely came home with me. This was on my purchase list. It was on my wish list before I ever got there, and it delivered. So this is Steve Madden. It has a tie around the waist for a belt. Can definitely wear this with no tie or no belt, and I feel like it kind of looks like a blazer, so it looks really, really nice on. This is a great workwear coat. I love the length of this one. It's a little bit shorter. And then I paired that with this dress. This one was from my lookbook. If you caught my lookbook a couple of days ago, I don't know what it was, but I thought this dress was tweed in the lookbook, which I love the look of, but I don't really like the feeling of tweed. This is actually a really, really soft, lightweight sweater fabric. So it's knit, it is incredibly soft. This one came home with me as well. I am wearing the small in the try-on, but I purchased the medium in this one just for a little bit of extra room. This is another great sweater dress that definitely came home with me this year. I love this tan color. It's beautiful on. This is a little bit thicker of a knit fabric than the dress I was just talking about, but this would also be a great workwear option. You could even take the tie belt off and do it with a leopard belt or something that's a little bit fancier if you were doing it for an event or for workwear. I have the small in this one. Little bit of an honorable mention here. This coat was beautiful. It caught Cody and I's eyes both as we walked past it. And Cody was like, you have to try that coat on. Unfortunately, in store, all they had was a medium. I really needed the small in this one, so it does look a little bit big on. But I love the length of this. The colors are stunning, and I think this would be a great fall outerwear piece. This little athleisure set also came home with me. I guess I'm sharing all the things that I ended up purchasing first. So Beyond Yoga is one of my favorite athletic wear lines. Just absolutely the softest fabric you will ever feel, but it still stays really nicely on your body. So this tank is a little twist front, and then the leggings have the V at the front. And I also paired them with my cute Adidas sneakers and this little Sherpa pullover. Another casual outfit option, plaid shacket or shirt jacket, is always on my list for fall. And this one is unique because it is a fleece fabric. So it's very, very soft and it comes down super long. So this one definitely will cover your booty if you want to wear with leggings, which is a major plus for me, and can really operate as a true outerwear piece or as a jacket. So I'm in the small in this one. It runs very oversized, and I also wore it with a great pair of classic black leggings by Zella. These always sell out every year, and they're a great fall staple, and this Led Zeppelin graphic tee. Here's another really cute dress option, and bonus points for this one because you can wear this one now. So sometimes I feel like shopping the anniversary sale can be exciting, but also difficult because you can't wear these items until it gets cold out. So this is one you can wear with sandals now, and then you can definitely style in the way that I did as the temps start getting cooler with boots and a hat, and I had the small on in this one. high sellout risk for this next one. This I have had on my wish list for years, and I finally was able to snag one in store, and I hope that there are enough in stock by the time you see this video that you can snag one too. So this is a camel colored pullover piece. I think they call, I don't know, we call these maybe Ruana, I might be saying that wrong, poncho kind of piece. Anyways, this one is sewn at the sleeve, so it is great for layering. I love to do it with like a striped long sleeve tee underneath and leggings. You can dress it up with some mules or booties like I did. This is also really cute to do over a long sleeve dress and belt it. So many different ways to wear this, and it is one size fits all. Here's a closer look at the Uggs on with another little casual outfit. These are those same black Zella leggings. Then I paired those with this simple ribbed shirt that's just one of those great layering pieces you can wear with anything. This one's really lightweight. And then I did it with a cropped puffer vest. So I had the small one in the puffer vest. That's what they had available in that color in store. Definitely would have preferred the medium. I'd say these run on the smaller side. Another quick shirt jacket option, if you want something that's a little pop of color for the fall, I think this is a great one. This is a corduroy fabric, really pretty green color. I just threw it on as a pullover piece and left it buttoned. Obviously, this would be really easy to do with a graphic tee under, leave it unbuttoned. You could do a tank, and you can wear this as a jacket piece too. And I have the medium in this one. How fun is this Free People skirt? I was in love with this thing. It's blue, it's floral. The bottom of it is so unique and fun. It's kind of flowy. I will say this fabric has no stretch to it whatsoever. So I was in the 4 here. I think I might have even preferred the 6. Just because it's a little bit tight on the booty area. The bottom is nice and flowy, and I think it's really cute with booties and a sweater. I did not intend on buying this outfit, but when I put it on, I was like, I don't know where I'm gonna wear this, but I need this stinking outfit. It is so cute. Little plaid mini skirt, just absolutely adorable. Something about the fit of this is so flattering. It hits at exactly the right spot. It's actually elastic around the back, so it's pretty comfortable. It does zip up the side, and it's not too short while still being a mini. And then this sweater actually really surprised me when I got it on. I feel like it's very slimming with a higher neckline, a little bit of a longer extended shoulder, and then it's ribbed at the bottom. So I have medium in both of these pieces too. Couple more casual pieces. These are the leggings or joggers by Zella. I really, really love this color, and this fabric is kind of like a super lightweight, almost like moisture wicking type fabric. It does not cling to the skin at all, which I love. These would be great for workouts or traveling. And then this little quarter zip comes in tons of colors and is a nice affordable option from BP. Here's a good classic fall look. I think this cardigan is going to be very popular, and I feel like this would actually be a great one just to wear around the house and lounge in. I don't think I've ever seen a longer, more comfy, cozy cardigan. This thing dang near hits the floor. It is so comfortable. It feels like a big blanket. I actually like it dressed up a little bit with jeans and a nicer top. These are just a simple straight leg jean by Levi, and then the top is a simple floral top, and then I paired it with my favorite mules. Lastly, I did not end up coming home with any of these pieces from this last outfit, but I debated long and hard on these jeans. I really love these jeans. I think they are crazy flattering. If you've been looking to try out a flare jean, these are a great intro into that. I ended up just not purchasing because I have a similar pair of flare jeans at home, but I think the wash is gorgeous on. I think they would pair really, really well with some fall boots or booties. And then this is a Free People sweater. I actually had it tucked into my bra so that it wasn't quite as long so that I could show the jeans. This actually is incredibly long. It's like their big oversized sweater. Could definitely wear this one with leggings, and it would also be great around the house too. Alrighty, that's a wrap on the Nordstrom Anniversary Sale. This year, I will be showcasing everything that I got in a future video when the sale opens to everyone, not just card holders. So keep an eye out for that. You can check all the links in the video description, and I'll see you next time.